Hello, good day audience, hope everyone is doing good. So this is concept number 2 on the hypothesis testing A-level mathematics 9709 statistics 2. As discussed in the previous lecture, we talked about how we do hypothesis testing for the Poisson mean. So it is the same approach if we have to solve a question on the binomial distribution for hypothesis testing. Students need to understand, in the previous question we talked about a one-tail test in which we test whether the mean have increased or not. In today's question, we will be talking about whether the mean have decreased or not, okay, whether the probability have decreased or not. So let's have a look at the question. Understand, it's a recent paper, May-June 2024, paper 6, variant 1. How do you solve discrete variables questions for hypothesis testing binomial distribution? You will follow the same approach, the 5 steps approach of the hypothesis testing: defining your variable, stating the null and alternative hypothesis, what is the test value, significance level, what is the critical region or the rejection region, and then carrying out the test, finding the probability, comparing it with significant level, and then making your conclusions by either accepting H0 or rejecting H0. So let's get started, students. The question says that every July, as part of a research project, Rita collects data about sightings of a particular kind of bird. Then each day in July, she notes whether she sees this kind of bird or not, and she records the number X of the days on which she sees the bird. So basically, our variable will be X is the number of the days on the birds can be seen, okay? X is basically number of the days that particular kind of bird can be seen. Number of days that kind of bird can be seen. That is basically our variable, which is defined as X, students. Next thing we need to understand is basically going further on. She models the distribution of X by the binomial 31, P, which means that 31 is the number of observations and P stands for probability of the success. Next, P is the probability seeing this kind of bird on a randomly chosen day in July. Data from the previous year suggests that probability is 0.3, but in 2022, Rita suspected that the value of P has been reduced. This is the statement which will be telling, this is the information, students, which will be telling us that whether our null or that will be telling us what will be our null and alternative hypothesis. So we have, sir, the null hypothesis, which is going to be that the probability is 0.3, and we have, sir, the alternative hypothesis, which will be telling us that the probability is less than 0.3, or the probability had reduced from 0.3. Please understand, students, these are still one tail test, okay? The previous example and this lecture as well, these are all one tail test in which you test for either the increase or the decrease. We'll talk about the two tail test as well soon. Students need to understand that hypothesis testing is not a difficult topic if you go according to the format, follow the steps and solve it, and understands the rejection region and the test value. Next the examiner have given the data in July 2024. July Rita saw this kind of bird on 4 days. So Rita is sawing this type of bird on 4 days, which means that our test value is basically 4, that the test value is basically 4. Then the examiner tells itself that you have to use the binomial distribution. The significance level is 5%, whether Rita's suspicions is justified or not, for 5 marks at the 5% significance level. So you start about that you have been given your test value, the statistic value. You will say that X follows a binomial distribution 31, probability to be tested 0.3, and you will be finding out, students, the probability of X is less than equals to 4, because 0 less than equals to 4 means that it will be probability of X is equals to 0, 1, 2, 3, and the probability of 4 as well, okay? Once you find this probability, we will get the answer and we will then judge whether this value lies in the critical region or not in the critical region. Then we are going to compare it, students, with the 5% significance level. So if the probability of x will be less than equals to 4, and that the, whatever the answer comes, if it is less than 5%, it means that we will have to reject the H naught, because that 4 will be lying in the critical region. We will have to reject that. So how do you find the binomial probability? It's very simple. It will be, sir, 31C0 into the probability of failure power of 31 times of probability of success to the power of 0. That's how you do 31C1 into probability of failure, 31 minus 1, that is 30, into 0.3 to the power of 1, the probability of success. Okay, is everyone getting it, following? So hope students are understanding. Please do ask any questions in the comment section if there is any problem or any questions here. Next one will be 30 plus 31C to the 2 into probability of failure, 29 power of 29, multiply by 0.3 to the power of square, and 31C3 into 0.7 to the power of 28 to multiply by probability of success, 0.3 to the power of cube. And the last one will be 31C4, which will be, sir, into 0.7 to the power of 27 and times of 0.3 to the power of 4. Whatever the answer comes, let's do it in the calculator and see what is our answer coming, students. And then we'll make the conclusion, compare with the test statistic value as well. So the probability of x is less than equals to 4 is basically coming, students, 0 point after doing the calculation. It is coming, sir, 0.0239, okay? 23 significant figures, 0.039. which we understand is basically less than 5% or less than 0.05, which means, students, that the x value, which is 4, it lies in the critical region. And if anything lies in the critical region, you have to give the conclusion, you have compared it, that you have to reject H naught. You have to reject H naught. And with a concluding statement, there is sufficient evidence at 5% significance level. There is sufficient evidence at 5% significance level. There is sufficient evidence at 5% significance level that the probability of seeing the bird is decreased. Okay, probability of the bird seeing the bird has decreased. So the probability of seeing the bird has decreased. So you have to make sure, give the conclusion statement as well. Okay, so that is how the marks will be. Let's talk about the marking split as well. Students need to understand that they get one mark for writing down null and alternative hypothesis. They will get one mark for finding out the probability and doing the comparison. So two marks are here for finding out the probability of x is less than equals to 4 and then comparing it with the 5% significance level. And then we have two marks for whatever the decision is with the concluding statements. So these are the steps that will give you all the correct marks. That is how we solve a hypothesis testing for the binomial distribution when we have discrete variables. When we have discrete variable, students, please make sure to ask questions and practice further questions on it. And hope everyone understood and get it. Have a great day. Thank you, students.